Welcome to Adrian's Corner and another episode of Gaming News. On today's show, we'll discuss BioWare's retrospective on 2021 and their need to rebuild their reputation as a company. We'll talk about BioWare's future and what went wrong these past couple of years. It's everything BioWare, starting now. On January 6th, BioWare General Manager Gary McKay wrote about the studio's 2021 experiences in a post called State of BioWare and Looking Ahead. In it, McKay focused on the challenges of the pandemic and the upsides of a newer, more flexible work model for their employees, all the while reiterating the laser-like focus that the company has on rebuilding their damaged reputation. And indeed, 2021 was a mixed bag for the company. First, you had its publisher, EA, deciding to pull the plug on Anthem's reboot, which was arguably the right decision considering the toxic reputation the game had received. Yet, it was a choice that was a blow to the reputation of a developer that has rarely misfired quite so badly. As BioWare Austin studio director Christian Daly said, "I know that this will be disappointing to the community of Anthem players who have been excited to see the improvements we've been working on. It is also disappointing for the team who were doing brilliant work. And for me personally, Anthem is what brought me to BioWare, and the last 2 years have been some of the most challenging and rewarding experiences of my career." Now, things would improve in 2021 for BioWare after this, as Mass Effect Legendary Edition was released back in May of 2021. And BioWare did the right thing here and treated the game with the care and respect it deserved, and the reception was incredibly positive across the board, which breathed new life and anticipation for the future of the series, which in turn has been fed by various teases and hints of what is yet to come. So back to the article then written by McKay back here on January 6th. He also touched on upcoming titles including the Dragon Age game series, saying that, "Of course, we remain hard at work on the next iterations of Dragon Age and Mass Effect. I'm seeing some incredible work from both teams. If you are curious about Mass Effect, I encourage you to take a look at the poster we released on N7 Day. If you look closely, there are a handful of hidden treats. By my count, there are at least 5 surprises, all of which point to an amazing future in the Mass Effect universe. As for Dragon Age, we have a veteran group of talented developers working on the next iteration of the franchise. We are focused on a single-player experience that is built on choices that matter." Now, that last line in particular is important. It essentially is a promise that BioWare will not pull an Anthem on this game. This was undoubtedly an effort to drive home the point that the rumor mill, which has been suggesting for quite some time that the next Dragon Age game was planning on incorporating elements of a live service, were no longer to be the case. You see, back in 2019, Electronic Arts had committed itself to live service games, a term which generally refers to games being structured around persistent online elements, which you can find in games like Destiny 2. Electronic Arts CEO Andrew Wilson said, "Games as a service is going to be foundational to our industry." And later that same year, during an October earnings call, Chief Financial Advisor Blake Jorgensen said that EA was doubling down on live services. And so, as a result, there was a lot of concern from fans that EA was planning to turn Dragon Age 4 into a multiplayer-focused Anthem-style live game, which critics described as Anthem with Dragons. While still others in the rumor mill were quoted as saying that while the main story was still going to be a single-player experience, the multiplayer would be more focused on post-release content, similar to Mass Effect 3's multiplayer. However, this appears to now not be the case, as EA apparently has decided to remove all multiplayer components from Dragon Age 4 and make it an exclusively single-player experience. According to sources, the decision was largely driven by two games. One was the single-player action game Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, which was a success for EA, and the other was Anthem, the Destiny-like live game that spectacularly imploded. Now, regardless of what was previously planned, it is reassuring to hear that BioWare is retooling to go back to the roots of their games. And so it would seem that the phrase single-player focused is something that you should hear variants of again and again going forward. BioWare is intent on driving home the message to all of their fanbase that Dragon Age will not be a live service game. So why does this matter? Well, even though Anthem was not mentioned in the January 6th post by McKay, the presence of the game and its failure is still felt. As McKay put it, "When I took on the GM role, I talked about rebuilding our reputation, and that remains a huge priority. We are laser-focused on building back the trust of our fans and community, and we plan to do that by delivering the types of games that we are best known for and ensuring that they are the highest quality. We want the launch of our games to be seminal moments in the industry." Now, this shows that the direction of the company is headed in the right direction. In a time where not all game developers or publishers have been focused on the wants and desires of their fan base, and I'm looking at you, Saints Row developer Volition, with your not backing down on this game, we get it, it's new, and it's a shock reaction to a reboot like no other. This was their response to sizable portions of their fanbase expressing disappointment and concern over the direction of the reboot. In fact, not only did Volition ignore the concerns of their own audience, but they openly mocked their fanbase with replies like this to a Twitter post in which the devs were accused of borrowing the art style from Fortnite. As the Saints Row Twitter team put it, "We don't think you know what Fortnite looks like, but you do you." Now look, I get it. Sometimes you might just have idiots running your social media platforms. But it is never a good look, and it never results in growing your brand. It's idiocracy at its finest. Of course, time will tell if mocking your own fan base will come back to haunt you, Volition, which I suspect it will. In any case, back to the topic at hand. It would appear that BioWare has seen the light and is focused on creating successful launches to its games, rather than bowing to pressures that would certainly hurt the reputation and growth of the company. A reassuring direction if there ever was one. And that, my friends, brings our episode to a close once more. As always, thank you so much for being with me here today. From Adrian's Corner, I'm Adrian, and I'll see you all next time.